Hey there, everyone. I hope you are doing very, very well. My name is Samantha Attard. I'm a wellness coach, yoga instructor, nutrition PhD living in Washington, D.C., and we are here again for another wonderful yoga session. So really, really happy to have you guys. We're going to be doing some yoga poses to help you have better posture. So this is really important. This is not just about standing up and looking good. It turns out that having good posture is going to really help you, especially if you have any low back pain, any pain when you're sitting or standing. So many of my clients that I'm working with, they're having muscular issues in their backs, whether it's at the top or at the bottom, when they're being still or when they're moving. And so we really work a lot on posture to make it so that their backs really stop hurting. So we're gonna be doing a few different poses today to help you with your posture. And so today we're gonna just do a little bit of yoga. I'm gonna show you three different poses that will help you feel your best and reduce your back pain. Yeah, so if anyone else sits at a computer for most of the day, this little thing starts to happen, which is not good for you. It actually adds all of this tension all through your body. So actually when you start to like kind of crunch in, it makes you feel more tired, you're more closed off. You also feel less energy, and then also it can add to some tension, so you're actually tightening up all of your muscles, and then you feel not so good because you're all tight up. The reason why yoga is so great for helping you with your posture and also just your day is that it helps you lower down your shoulders and relax through your entire body. So we're gonna do some poses to help strengthen up your core muscles today, because when you have weak core muscles, it leads to an overly flexible back, and that's when you start to overstretch it in different ways. So we're gonna work on relaxing your upper back, your neck, your the base of your skull, all these muscles in here. Also, it's strengthening up your lower belly. For neck pain, sometimes it is that we tend to be pushing our heads forward, so you want to be pulling it back, keeping your chin nice and level, not reaching way up or tucking way down. And a chiropractor really can help you put that back in line for your neck, so that's also a really nice thing. But also just learning how to relax those muscles through your back and neck are also going to be really helpful. I'm going to go over back there so you'll be able to see my entire body as I show you some of these poses that we'll do for posture. Okay, let's get going. So, the first pose that we're gonna do for posture is Tadasana. It's mountain pose. And this is a pose that we really wanna find every, a good neutral position that we wanna have basically every time that we're standing. So it's a very intentional, active standing pose. And you're just kind of standing, but it's very active and intentional. And if you practice this pose, just when you're standing, waiting for the bus, waiting in line at the grocery store, standing up anywhere, really, you will start to feel so much better through your body. So here's how we do it. First thing you want to do is make sure that your feet are hips width distance. So hips width distance is actually about two fists between your feet. So it's not really wide. So if you need to check it out, you can always bend over, find your two fists, and then your feet are right on the outside. You want the outsides of your feet to be parallel, your big toes to be turned in just a little bit. And what I really like to do here is actually lift up my toes, spread my toes out, and then put all my toes back down to the ground. This is obviously a little harder if you have your shoes on, but give it a try. It's really amazing. You'll find that all of your toes can spread out, and then you place everything back down onto the ground. Now that you're here on your feet, you want to start to find your center of gravity. So move a little bit left to right, a little bit front to back, and really find a place where you feel really even. So again, between your left and right, between your front and back, all of your weight is completely centered down towards the center line of your body. So between front and back, between left and right, your weight is coming straight down towards the center. Next thing too is taking care of your upper body. So you're going to roll your shoulders back, have your palms face forward, so your palms face forward, and you pull your shoulders and blades back and down, so your shoulders really sink down. They get super heavy here, and again, you're going to feel like you're pulling down through your hands so that all of your weight is again moving towards your center line. Now, one thing I forgot to mention about your legs, you might want to have a tiny, tiny bend in your knees. So if you feel like you're locking out with your knees, like they're really tense, you're just going to relax them slightly, palms face forward. You're going to pull your belly button in and feel your tailbone down towards the ground. So you want to feel like your butt's not sticking out like this. You want to pull it in and feel your tailbone is reaching down to the ground as your belly button pulls in towards your spine and then up a little bit. So almost like there's like a circle. So your belly is pulling up and in and your back is pulling in and down. So that's the feeling that you want to have in your low belly. So you pull your belly in, tailbone sinks down, palms face forward, shoulders really nice and relaxed here. You have a nice open chest. Now we talked a little bit about your neck. You want to make sure that you're not straining it up, pulling it in, or anything like that. Nice and even, your chin is parallel with the floor. And then you stand right here. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. Another two breaths. Keep pulling your belly up in. And then you can release that pose. But it actually takes a lot of work, right? Like I'm just standing. But it actually takes a lot to find that even weight, to take that nice, gentle bend in your knees, pull your belly up and in, tailbone sinking down, shoulders back, chin level. And if you do that every time, again, you come to, if you're standing at the grocery store, or you're at a meeting, or you're in line somewhere, take a second. Find your feet, find your center of gravity, bend in your knees, belly up and in, chest back, chin level. Oh my God, your life will change so, so much because you'll find this really great relaxed posture. Your shoulders will relax so that you release a bunch of tension. You'll also start to firm up your belly and be strengthening your core muscles and learn how to engage your abdominals. And you'll also not get tired in the same way because you won't be resting on one foot and then the other. You're going to find even weight between your left and your right, and that'll feel really awesome. And again, because you'll be pulling your tailbone down, you get length through your low back, which is where a lot of us get pain. And so you'll lengthen through your low back, and it'll start to spread out and feel really nice. So that's our first pose. It's called Tadasana, or mountain pose. Really, really great pose to help you with your posture. The next pose we'll be doing is to help a little bit with your core, but also to start to strengthen the muscles through your back. So to come to this pose, you're actually going to come down to lie down on your belly. And this is called locust pose. So you're going to lie down on your belly, take your hands out by your sides, palms face down, your chin faces towards the ground, and you want to press into the tops of your feet, get really active through your legs so you feel your knees lift. And the first thing you're going to do is press into your hands and lift your shoulders and chin up. Now keep your gaze down towards the ground so there's length through the back of your neck. But keep pressing into your hands and your feet as you lift your chest up off the ground. And so this is using all of my upper back to help lift me up. And then I lower myself down. Then you can do the other side. So press your hands and your chin into the ground and lift your feet up out of the sky. So now I'm using my low back to lift my feet up. And I'm pulling my feet back in space. So it's all about the strength of my lower back. Then I lower my feet down. And then we'll do both sides. So reach your hands up, feet up, chest up, chin up, everything lifts. And this is your full locust pose. You get super long, crown of your head reaches long. And this takes so much strength through your back. Try to relax through your glutes here. Use your back and not your butt. And then you lower yourself down to the ground. You can rest your cheek on the ground. You give your hips a little wiggle. Give yourself a breath, and then it's nice to do it a second time. So I recommend doing this at least three times where you bring your chin down to the ground. Inhale, reach everything off the ground. Really pull your shoulders back, reach your hands toward your feet, lift your toes up, so much length. And then lower your body down to the ground. Again, chin can come down to the mat. You give your hips a little wiggle. So that's locust pose. And again, what that pose is really doing is strengthening all of your back as you lift up off of the ground. And that will really help to strengthen your back muscles so that you can then use it for your better posture. The next thing that we talk about, this is our third pose for better posture, is strengthening your core. And And this is a really, really important one to help you have strong fronts of your abs so that your back muscles can also be strong. Usually our back is overcompensating, but if we actually strengthen up our bellies and we use our core rather than our spine to when we move things, lift things, do anything like that. So strengthening up your core will help you lengthen out through your spine. And so for this pose, we'll work on the vasana, which is both poses. So you're going to keep your feet here on the ground first, knees nice 90 degree angle, hands come behind your thighs, and you're going to lean your body back slightly. Then you're going to start to lift your feet up and take your shins parallel to the ground. Keep your feet nice and active. You can keep holding on to the backs of your thighs, or you can reach your arms out. Now, if this feels good, maybe you start to strengthen out your legs, you reach your toes up into the sky and open up your shoulders. And you can be anywhere here, so you can be here with your arms back, your arms out, or your feet straight. Either one works, so just keep doing wherever you are, keep practicing this pose, and you will keep getting better, I promise. Open through your shoulders, so you have a nice open chest, lengthen your head up, maybe you reach your arms up above your head, really reach tall. And then you can lower your feet down to the ground. Now, this is such a great pose for helping you find all of this length through your back and through the front of your body. So really practice it out. It is not an easy pose, I know it. But if you spend more and more time finding this balance, practicing it, your body will get stronger and you'll be able to do it. The other thing I want to mention for your boat pose is to really think about length in your back. Some people really round. You don't want to be rounding through your back because you want to be pulling up, opening your chest. So you can see that difference. If you're not acting like this, this is not going to help your posture. You're going to pull your back up. So that's what you're working for here. So we've talked about three different poses for better posture. Tadasana, your mountain pose, standing up tall, belly pose in, even weight between your left and your right. We did locust pose, lying on your belly and using your back to lift your body up and find some more flexibility. And then Navasana, boat pose, balancing on your hips, using your core to help hold your body up so you strengthen out the front of your body. So hopefully these three poses, if you really do them every single day, trying to, you will strengthen up your spine and get a lot better posture. You will wake up all of the muscles in your body, and oh my gosh, is it also just such a great energy boost. So I'd love to take any questions you guys have about yoga or yoga poses or yoga for posture. So if you guys have any questions, always give me questions over on Twitter or Instagram. My handle is Happy Healthy Sam. Also really love Snapchat, so you can definitely find me there. Again, you can find me on my own Periscope channel. I'm Happy Healthy Sam. Also on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat at Happy Healthy Sam if you want to catch daily recipes, yoga poses, things that I'm doing. I have a specific set of poses that I do every single day. You know, I definitely always try to get a downward facing dog in, lots of planks and chaturangas, sun salutations, which you can Google, and we should probably do some more of around here. Sun salutations is a great way to just generally wake up my body. There's something about hitting a warrior two and a reverse warrior that just opens my entire side body up that I really, really love. So those are things that I really, I love to do. But I don't have a specific set or a specific routine that I do the same every single day. But I do always get some downward facing dogs, some planks and chaturangas, and my warrior twos and reverse warriors in. So those ones I try to hit every single day. Plus some good seated meditation, a good shavasana to lie on my back, really release down, relax my body. Those are the big important ones. Another thing that you might really like if you're having upper back pain, depending on which direction it's in, sometimes it's really nice to just take your hands behind your back, straighten your elbows, open up through your chest. You might find that that really helps you stretch everything out and stretch out the front of your chest. Often we have back pain because we're going like this all of the time. So definitely open on up. In yoga, are the poses in a specific order for a more flowing movement? Exactly. Yes, they totally are. That is the point of a vinyasa yoga sequence, is that it is all about flow, but also about waking your body up in specific ways. You know, if you try to just
suddenly go into some crazy handstand without having done any warm-up first, you would actually hurt your muscles. So it's about slowly waking up your body, getting more energy, and loosening everything up, strengthening everything up, and then doing some more deep stretches now that you've actually gotten in there. So it's a really great thing, and so energizing and then calming down, it's really great. Foam rolling, I personally don't do it that much. It can feel really good. It's not actually making you like more flexible, but it can help loosen up some tension. So it's a nice thing. I'm not obsessed with it though, and I don't recommend it as being the end all, be all, cure all. It just tends to just feel good. Definitely, there's a beautiful thing. You can look up some information about yoga sequencing. I work with people over Skype to help develop a yoga sequence just for them, so then you'll be able to do it on your own and have a set of poses that you can do. So if that's something that you're interested in, I would love to talk about working with you on developing a yoga sequence that's specifically designed for your goals, and then you can then do at home by yourself, or work with me over Skype on it. So if that's something you're interested in, would love to chat. My name is Sam at behappyhealthyhuman.com. Thank you so, so much for joining. And again, if you have any questions, Happy Healthy Sam on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat. I'd love to see you there. And I hope you have a beautiful, wonderful, energetic, happy day.